Today I want to speak about the relationship between men and women, women and men, en alle andere vormen die and all other forms of relationship which are defined by this word relationship between two different people. The relationship between men and women is a basic relationship in the bouw van de society and also in bouw van de cultuur van de society. Each relationship heeft his own personal cultuur en die deze cultuur this culture defines zich in the framework of big collective culture and often big language language area where people speak the same language. We know how difficult in our days, in these days, men may say, the relationship as such, because every human is in the Western technological world of our days is different, is personal. But many elements of relationship are defined still from the structures from the past, because many people reproduce in the actual relationship which they have seen of the parents, of the grandparents, of the neighbors when they were young. For me, most important element of modern relationship is the structure of relationship. This structure defined the healthiness of this relationship from now to the future. My definition of relationship based on the form 100-200. However, most relationship based on the form 50-50. So 50 myself and 50 for compromise. I think the modern relationship especially not must build on compromises. They must be built up understanding what is this relationship, and also especially understanding of the structure of the relationship. My definition of the love between two people, whatever age they have, after they become autonomous and separate from their parents as humans. this relationship are based on the structure which people, both partners of the relationship, are daily keep alive. So 100-100 is not a special structure of the relationship. It is a vision how I see the relationship and how I like that people see the relationship. In the healthy relationship, each person must be feel himself or herself and feel free to change, because healthy relationship are built on permanent change of people, because modern people are permanently in the process of transition and changing and growing. For me, it's most important, it's process of growing, so that the person who are in the relationship can grow further each day, each week, each year, and each decennia, each 10 years, and each 20 years, and so on, and so on. The definition what I did put in many speeches about paradise of the childhood, or childhood in paradise, in Eden, also can be used in the relationship between two adult people. So to say that, and it sounds pretty strange, but it is very serious. The love without structure is the way to the hell. That is very important speaking, because already in childhood I could show that the love to the child without structure is have the same consequences is the way to the hell for the child. But in relation between two people who already know children, structure is the third element in this construction. So it is a driehoekig element. Triangle. Two people and the structure, which metaphorically we can compare with a tree, just metaphorically speaking, this tree, this is a symbolic metaphor of the structure between these two. And each person keep this tree healthy with his own meaning, which are different from the meaning of the other person, because both person came from different cultures, not different cultures in the big meaning, but just they always unique, they always different. Dus even in the between the same culture, they are different. The individual culture of these two is different. That's why so important to build this tree, which I call the metaphor and symbol of the relationship. We must always keep this tree alive, what I say, every day, every week, every year, and so on and so on. Why? So, because as a living organism, it needs water, it needs fooding, it have influence of the elements, different elements. It could be the same what's happened in the open nature, storms, drought, rains, all kind of terrifying things, and also nice thing, but problem is the thing which can damage this tree of structure, tree of structure of the relationship. And what is important, that these two people must not become copying of each other. And that's why this relationship, for me, I defined with this mathematics, 100-200. And not 50-50, where 50 is open for the compromise. So this tree of relationship is each what is different for from these two people who are in a relationship, and the starting of relationship very often, especially if you're young, based on instincts and chemical processes, and so it is very, very important to know how to build relationship, not from experience of your parents, but from the point of view, from the wisdom. And what is the wisdom of? It is a small wisdom, it is just a reflection of the wisdom, but anyway, it is a reflection of the wisdom, relationship, which are built on the lived and structure. We see already here that lived, which are based on the feelings, and difference between feelings and emotions, that feelings are based on long time feelings, and emotions on a short time feelings. And love in this relationship, what I describing, is it is not so active element. This is, if we speak about passion, which based on the instincts, that is something different from love. But love as such, it is not so active element in the relationship. Most active element in relationship is the structure. And the structure is the building of the relationship, but it is not an architectural project, that is a living project. So that's why I compare it with tree, and that's why it's so important to understand that taking care about this tree of structure is also motivated by love. That's why love in the relationship must not be very active, because then it can be possessed by emotions and can be possessed by instincts, possessed by the passion based on instinct, and the passion where the instinct connected with ego. This all possible if they have a small part in the big structure of the relationship. But the structure, it is most important most important waarover must be waarin about which must be spent more intellectual energy and more brain energy, and also in the first periods, very important is the instinctive knowledge about the relationship. This instinctive knowledge young people don't have, because there is no intuitive knowledge, I want to say. There is no knowledge of intuition without knowledge. Intuition always operate with knowledge as chess player. So no knowledge, no chess play, and no intuition. So the structure is the living process which must kept by two people who are in the relationship. Also, relationship in this form of 100-100 have another very important element, if not to say very important element. In the modern world, people are less and less interesting in the other person if the other person have problem. That's why there are so many psychiatrists, all kind of help for the people in problem. You must pay, and that they are the professionals. They must help you. Especially psychiatrists will help you with medicine. But that's nothing to do with your healthy relationship to other person. That's why 100% is so important, but also it's not so easy. It is not so what goes just the easy way. It is maybe more easy to make compromise and then to be swallowed by the rain of compromises. And op een moment in you just live in this masses in the water waterland of compromises, where it's not so easy to come out on the dry land. So relationship, and many people who have a relationship in not so young age, they always say relationship is a work. But I not want to say that it is work, because if the love is the motivation to keep this tree of relationship alive, green and healthy, we don't speak about work. We speak about love in action. And that's why what I mean with the slowly love. The love which which is not in hurry to show itself. Because without love, relationship are very shaky. Because there is then question, why I am in this relationship? Just investigate the structure, but there is no structure without love in relationship with two people which are adults, grown up. Thus, if I return to this modern world where there is no interesting to one person in a problem, it is very often that other people expecting you to give a pleasure to the temporary meetings what you have with other people, and in any way not to be a problem to them, because every modern person, the person from these days, will say, I have enough problem, I just want to have a good time. So what expecting is easy going, to be easy and not to be difficult. An only relationship which is based of this long time love, long time, I wanted to say this slow going love, ever present, and not which is not always trying to show itself, but always present, because without love there is no healthy relationship, and there is not no, there is not this spontaneous way try to understand the other person which is not me. And relationship is always between two strangers. And only in modern relationship, 100 to 100, can one person be himself or herself, be itself in changing changing manifestation of itself. Only there, there is a relationship, the other can meet you with all your problems. Because that's why relationships are important. It is not only based on drift of the body, instincts, and chemical processes. It's also this meeting of the feelings, also short emotions. But later I can show that emotions and feelings is so different in hun mechanical process that is very important to understand what is that emotion and what is that feeling. So relationship is not a closed castle as it was in past. It is a situation based on the three corners of existence. One participant of relationship, as a participant of relationship, and the structure of the relationship. And the love is each would always moving in this constellation. Because love give also this passion to wait, for another person to say something what is important for other person. And this relationship, what I repeat again, very important, because all the meaning of this relation 100 to 100% is growing of the person, growing mentally, emotionally, feeling in the feelings way, growing in spiritual way. And for me, the direction of this growth is the wisdom. So it is not a grow for the sake of grow. It is not a grow just to have more possibility, because you have that grow means a more financial possibility. Growth in this relationship means growth in the direction of the wisdom. And that is not easy way. Because of our culture. So now I turn the story a little bit as away. to continue speaking about the relationship, I just want to make a different turn of this story. And this turn is the story about the culture in which we are born, we are growing, we are collecting more and more knowledge about this culture, and then we are dying. And we left all these things which we are collected, all this money which collected to the other people. But the culture, in all these investigations which I make, come in a very different light. And the wisdom did help me to understand the meaning of culture. The basis of the culture, the basis of the culture built on some simple elements, and it is a language and image. To say it vaguely and to say it big, there is no culture without language. And there is no culture without image. That is how culture live in us. Through language and image. And there is also the mother culture. The culture of our birth, of the our place where we was born, the place where we did grow up, and the place where we starting to exist and to grow after the childhood. The culture, and especially the mother culture, this culture which we did learn from very beginning as a child, has very tricky way to how it function. I can say it so. Culture as such is a prison. Culture as such is very modern prison. And as a prison, it have a guardian. It have a people to keep people taking care about this prison, the guardians. Who is the guardian of this cultural building which I call prison? It is all inside, and it is very big. The guardian oh, this cultural prison, and it is a metaphor, and symbolische taal, the same time, metaphorical and symbolic language, is the pure evil. The pure evil is the chief guardian, the chief of the prison, and all these small guardians, they're working for him to keep this prison closed and not let people flee this prison. And also this guardian have all the keys. All the keys of from this prison, from all the doors, and this prison have many doors. There are many keys, all different forms and formats. And this pure evil, with this helping guardians, each position, all these moving guardians, they are not staying always in the same place, they're always busy. All these guardians have keys which they never will give to the people in prison, to the prisoner. They will never get this key, because Quad as such never want people escape this prison of culture. And that is a big secret of the culture. This is a big statement about the culture. But if we go further, I can ask this about following situation. Is there culture in paradise, in Eden? Is a culture in Eden? Was a culture in Eden if we look in the Bible? Culture. And we see that is what means paradise. In paradise there is no culture. In the paradise there is also no knowledge about good and evil. And we all know the story about forbidden tree and about forbidden fruit. What symboliseert en mythologiseert, maar ook symboliseert this story from the Bible. This is the childhood from every human people. How it is go from 0 to 7. I did spoke about this very, very elaborate. And this also explain us that the culture starts with knowledge of good and evil. So the culture learn me what is good, but also what is evil. And we see that evil is very active. If we did learn this lesson of culture, and if we are lost in all these images of violence, of problems of all these bad things in the world, where they are coming from, where is the place of birth, how we can help it. And that is the answer. The place of birth of the evil is in the culture, the human culture. And also, I can say, and I speak now to all people of the earth, all, because every human have a culture, short culture, different culture. But out, if he have language, he have culture. If he modulate the images inside of him with the language, he have culture. Because culture, through the language, make the choices of which image, will go there, and which image is important, and which image is not important, which sense is important, and which sense is not important, which word is important, and so on, and so on. But if we take to the starting of problem, that is how the problem is born. Culture is prison, and the evil, the bad man, the evil man is the guardian of this prison, and he have all the key. That's why we never get the key, and that's why we cannot escape from this prison. It seems to be so. Naturally, you can always escape. But at this moment, important to understand that we cannot escape the legal way, through the door, maybe through the window, which have key. Never. Through the window to the outside world, we can only see the glimpse of a free world. But we cannot be there, because we all bound under culture, and culture is the chain, and we sit in a chain gang. You know, we all sit and sell the chain, not every day. Of course, we can sometimes to go in the, it is a symbolic list to sing, in the playground in the prison, and a little bit to take fresh air, but it is just a short moment, and then we all will come back, and again the chain gang was our destiny. But why it is so difficult to liberate itself from the culture? What is the mechanism there? And the wisdom that helped me understand how it works. The chain and the sleutel, keystone of the prison, not keys, but keystone, which to block the walls, are built on this deadly, deadly grip of these two elements, image and language. And I speak about mother language, the language which come to us first and develop in us until we are we're growing. This basis mother language and mother culture, which were which surrounded us in this childhood, dus the language and the image and the deadly connection with each other. It is really deadly connection. It is almost not possible to break it. Because if we do it violently, we go be crazy. The only other way is the natural way, that we naturally, step by step, growing in understanding of this dilemma, of this problem. The problem is to break this deadly connection, this deadly glue with the best glue, just nailed together with all the nails. I just don't have enough metaphors to show how this deadly connection between the mother language and the image, they define the culture and they keep us in the prison of the culture. Any culture, every corner of the world, and I speak now to every people in each corner of the world. That is the way of liberating from this cultural prison. Whatever that cultural can means, there is word prison. Always it is prison. And we always have the guardian, the living person, they are always moving, they are always watching us, that we are not starting to make one way of another, as a Graf Monte Cristo, to keep trying to escape from this prison. No, they are always watching us, that we not escape. That's why it is so difficult to outbreak from this prison. And that's why we like so much all stories, all films, all theater play about escaping the prison. Because it sit very, very deep on biological language in us. It is not genetics, but it is op dat new level of instincts in us that wish to escape. But because we are all products of culture and we live in a culture and we search the way out through the culture, and I hope you can understand now why so few did really escape and did meet the wisdom. Or better to say, wisdom did meet them. Because you cannot meet wisdom how you are now. You must to experience and several changes so that wisdom will meet you. But if you're in the prison, you can only look at outside through the window in the prison, and you always cultures taking care that you always have broken self-consciousness, that the mirror of your self-consciousness is always broken, because you could only see the outside world through the window of the prison. That's why culture always taking care that your knowledge is partial and not the whole. Dus I don't speak that culture is the enemy. Because most of the people live in the culture, they grow up, they're making families, they're making, and it's all in this, as Australia long ago was the island of prisoners. So we can compare, so big. But I don't say that it's Australia. I just say long ago was so. Australia is very changed and it is not anymore the island of prisoners. But the prison of culture is very elaborate and is in zijn breedte, in zijn longevity so, is endless. Alleen culture is not deep. But in the direction naar links en rechts, rechts en left and right, it have no end. It's always will search naar new problems and new answers, create a new problem. But what is so important in culture? What is so important? It is the culture which developed our instruments inside of us. That's why it's so important to know culture from the bottom till the up. To know everything about culture. And you don't need to know everything about the culture, collective culture. No, the culture which you get. The culture which you get with your mother language, this is your mother culture. You must know everything about this because you must grow. And the culture will give you the best instruments in the world to understand this culture. And without this sharp, quick, elaborate instrument, you will never understand culture, and that's why you will never even understand that you are in a prison, because you cannot compare this prison with no non-prison. Yeah, you can read the books, but yeah, there are many fantasies in the book, and you know how many people will speak about all kind of strange things somewhere in the air. But if you are human from these days, you must be clever, you must be very sharp, your brain must be very quick, so that he can see his own thoughts. You see how quick it must be, so that your consciousness, that your inside seeing can see souls burn, grow, go naar beneden and disappeared. As a source grows, disappears. As a source, and this process just go on, and this process must go on, because source is the bloodstream of the brain. All the teachings we're speaking, you must stop thinking, you must go to feel. All this nonsense is just a damaging theories, damaging speaking, because the same, if you want to say, my blood must not move anymore because I don't want it and I don't need it. If your blood and your heart stop pumping and your blood not anymore come to the organ will die. If the brain stop with thinking, this region, this part of brain will die. And that's that we seen it by the old people who get all kind of strange illnesses. We see what's happened with the brain, which not think because of this illness. So we must always take care that our brain have something to eat. And eating from the brain is activating from the souls. But in the way to understand about the brain and his working and his process of souls making, that is all important so long we are in the culture, to understand how culture functions through our brain. That is so important to find the special methods, and they are, to make our brain go little bit slower. And our awareness, our seeing of the function of the brain, go quickly and sharper, so we can see the movement of brain as a river, and we as awareness sitting on the shore of this river, on the earth, on the place, and we can see how it's all move, and it must move, and we must take care that the brain can keep to sing. And the same with the feelings. We must always take care that the feelings which I live, metaphor is a heart, but they live in the brain, that the brain constant, continue create feelings and moving feelings and again and again, because that we can compare with lymphatic, just metaphor, eh? This not that is so is lymphatic waterstroom inside our body, also very important. So to continue, I will go in the following situation that the meaning of all the development, all growing inside spiritually and mystically, it means that we must to flee from this prison, and that we must we must to find us outside at the on the on the other side of this prison. Dus we must find the way to leave this prison, to escape from this prison. And this way, not one way, there are several ways, and each wise person, wisdom person, speaks about his vision about this. So, and I also can only speak about something what I know and what did help me to escape from this prison. And personally, in a short speaking, a big help for me was that I did leave the country where I was born, and I did not take my mother culture with me and my language. So I did not spoke my language about more than 35 years. I'm just starting to use it these days, since very short, to speak in this language between other languages. So when I stopped to use my mother language and mother culture also, slowly I started to understand how it did work. But to meet the wisdom, I had to travel a lot in the world until I met the wisdom. And then I had to come back and understand what I did learn, and also understand how it works inside me and what are the machinery inside me which kept me from understand wisdom, the meeting with the wisdom. So if I go further with this metaphor about prison, culture as a prison, and the guardians in the prison are always evil force, evil power, I must say what me did liberate from this prison is that I am consciously did broke this deadly mixture, that deadly connection between the language and the image. Just a minimal form. Zijn many images. Images are they are so many that there are no end of them. But I speak about the structural aspects of the function of our brain and function of the collective brain. Because people who live in the same culture, they have also collective brain. They have collective culture. And this collective culture always keep people on the place in this prison. Me did help that I consciously, so I was just, I did know what I did, and it was not learned from nobody. I just understood through my own personal experience I never heard about this, but I just discovered this, that culture is evil and the culture terrorized me. And also in the same time, I could understand all aspects of that personal culture, also as reflection of collective culture, because my brain and my heart did develop such speed, such clearness. They could see all the movement of the thoughts and feelings. But this was secondarily power. The first most important is discovery that the culture is a prison, culture is evil, and I must liberate myself from the culture. And so I could leave this prison. And so it is what happened. Because if I a little bit speak about this metaphor, prison, culture as a prison, and every person have own room in this prison, I should say that the matter who this prison are built is such that always there is a escape way, the way to escape. It is in the wall the exact profile of the person who live in this room, so that this escape is only possible for this unique person. And because the silhouette, it's just metaphor, the silhouette of this escape corresponded exact with silhouette of the person, so nobody else can go through this escape way. And so in each camera, in each room of this prison, everywhere there is unique escape place which are hidden, which are masked in the wall. But this is who the wall of the culture is built. If we read Kafka, Franz Kafka, we can often feel this tension of intuition about this. He don't speak openly because he did not know, but his intuition did say him about this escape. And many people of wisdom from thousands years ago, from all different places in the on the earth, in all different cultures from long ago, because all long ago became the tradition of wisdom and transporting wisdom from generation to generation, from hand to hand. Because knowledge about how to meet wisdom can be only you can only that get from hand to hand. It is a symbol, but this is from real person to real person, from living person to living person, and this way goes far deeper way to the beginning of the people as such. Not for nothing, Solomon in Bible when he speak about wisdom, when the wisdom did burn, how wisdom, what is wisdom, and I speak in the way that the method of speaking, he speak in the name of the wisdom. And he says that wisdom was born before the God began all his creative work. Solomon is the son, is the king of Israel, son of David. David was his psalms, and Solomon was his preaches, was his speaking. And I found this very interesting to see from this manager, from this thinker with the mind of the manager, how he speaks about the wisdom and how the wisdom was born and when. I found this very, very interesting. Yeah. It's never help this to read all these things, not help to liberate yourself from the culture and all the things which we must do and which we must liberate us gradually in the going of the years. But when you know, when you did met the wisdom, and when you meet the wisdom, and when you already just Adam, if you just get feeling. See, it is very difficult to speak about each what lines far away with the words living. But anyway, if you did, if the soul, better say, if the wisdom did met you, that if the wisdom did visit you, then you can understand these words and interpret them the right way. Because Solomon don't say literally how to meet the wisdom. I think that was also the intention of him, not discover the way, just to speak about it as something there. For me, wisdom was always most important what there is to learn about and to meet the wisdom. And so when I did found me on the other side of this prison of culture, I could slowly move. And then there came a special place where you must, which you must to cross. This is already far. There are no kilometers there, but it is far behind the prison. This, the cultural prison, was already long way away. And this metaphorically speaking, river, which you can also call the river of personal Rubicon, I can say it is the river of the death. This we will find often in mythological literature, such pictures about the river, but I speak what you really meet in your life, what has really happened to you, and what you really experience. And it is so that the wisdom lives on the other side of this river of death. So you have to die to cross this river and meet the wisdom. But I say it is not meet, that not you meet the prison, but wisdom meet you. And without crossing this river of death, not life and death, no, the river of dying, of death. That is the real Rubicon, spiritually and mystically speaking about. And then you have to spring from the shore in this river. But this river, in the moment you are just for the first time doing this, is absolutely unknown to you. You don't know what it is. You even don't know if you there is the wisdom. You don't know. And here, that's why when I showed which position must make this development what I'm basic, I showed especially about church, and that's why it's happened in Cassé church, because here in crucial moment only what you get to spring in this river, which is absolutely unknown, eh? And you know it is a river of death, and only what can help you is that you believe in it, that you believe in what you do is right. Dus we meet here the process of believing in each, the knowledge of something what you get from belief, pure, zuiver, absolute helder, absolutely clear belief in the meaning of the word of belief. You believe that what you are going to do is right. And that help you to spring in this river. Dus not the knowledge that you shall meet something beautiful and that you will just be happy. All the things already gone away because they are things of the culture and prison of culture, all far away. No, I speak about knowledge of death, which you get from the springing in the river, and only what you help to make this sprung, the spring, this step, the right way, the clear way, the your knowledge that what you're doing is right. And the basis process is the process of believing in in the righteousness of the step. That's why I call what I'm now doing Enkese Church, because question of belief. Belief and the crucial moment is the only force which can help you to make right decision and right actions. Then the time did go on. I don't know how long it was, but then I discover myself back to the shore of the river, in the metaphorically speaking, but it is bijna almost physically on the shore of this not anymore river, it was the ocean, the river, the changing ocean. And meanwhile, and you was brought back in the world of living people and living organism. And I, the last time I named this this show, this place, this sand shore as a silver shore and not as the golden shore as sometimes in the folks songs speaking about, that they're speaking more about as a sort of happiness, almost financial happiness, always that happiness that don't need to speak long about this, it's just very naive and very superficial. So this silver shore, silver just close to the ocean, and then you find yourself back to the life, and just you go back, and then what very very interesting happens, such a things, very beautiful things, you just go there and you go here and there, and one moment you are again, you meet this building of culture. And very strange, very beautiful, very, very wonderful that you can just go through this building what long ago was a prison. And you just go in and out, you go just through it, because it's just not so large. It is endlessly this way, because it's also the border, but if you go forth and back, it is pretty short. And you see all these people in prison who are working, who are just thinking that they are in prison, so they must work hard, they must doing all kind of things and taking care of thousand and thousand things. But you can just go and you see there is no any door there. And especially there is no any door which are closed. Not only so, you see in this building of culture that there is no any kind of guardian there. Because you did learn, don't see evil as such. it is not anymore something what intrigue you. It is something just not interesting. Just something what very banal, ordinary. But in the deepte, you just don't see it. That's why the guardian are gone for you. As a people, I think they see kind of guardians, but not you, because you can walk through all this building in where you can see all these beautiful things that culture are making, all these gadgets, all these apparatus, all these beautiful instruments. But you cannot be attached to these things. You just see the beauty of it, but you don't see the evil guardians of the cultural prison. Everybody see them, you not. That's why you can go in and out. And you can also go on the other side of the prison. Dus the other side of the prison is where the culture begins. And you can meet there the small children which are living on the other side of the prison, and they live in the children paradise, and they live in the children Eden. And you go further and you meet the begin of the world. World as cultural phenomena. You meet begin from all these things. You recognize them as such things. And so you can walk in the children paradise without meeting any evil around there, but you also don't see the good things the old way. You see them also very differently. They are not anymore coupled on the knowledge of good and evil. Here I can again to make a pause. A just very beautiful experience. You don't see the guardians of the prison because you don't see the evil things no more. It's very astonishing, very special. Yeah.